We love pie, of course, everyone loves pie, but one of my favourite pie facts is, and it's, I think it's fun, you only need 39 digits of pi to be able to measure the circumference of the observable universe within the width of one hydrogen atom. And that's all you need. So we write out the 39 digits.
Yep.
Oh, let's put it here. So the 39 digits of pi, it's 3 point. Now 3 counts as one of the digits, so it's now 38 decimal places. Let's do the 38 decimal places. 1, 4, 1, 6, 5, 9, 7, 9, 3, 2, 7, 4, 2, 0.
He didn't memorise that, everyone. There you go. Show him what you did, just in case.
Wolfram Alpha app. Yeah. Never leave home without it. Right.
So he's not a pie. You're not a pie memoriser, James.
No, I'm not. No, and that's another thing altogether. People who memorise this digit, you know, this pi figure to a massive amount of digits, but people who calculate it using computers have calculated it to currently 10 trillion digits of pi.
Go on, then, let's do them.
Okay.
All right. No.
So that would be all you need, and that's overkill as it is, because that's all you need to measure the circumference of the observable universe. So the observable universe is the distance that light has travelled since the Big Bang, and if we say it's, you know, travelled in a big sphere and a big bubble, then if we measure the distance around it, we'd have the circumference of the universe, and we would need pi to work out that circumference, and we could be as accurate as a hydrogen atom if we use just 39 digits of pi. We don't need to use the whole thing, of course, which goes on forever. So in fact, in practical day-to-day use in engineering, in real life, you would only need a handful of digits of pi to have an accuracy that would be suitable for anything that you need to do. So Wolfram Alpha told me that the diameter of the universe was 8.8 times 10 to the 26 meters. So that's the diameter of the observable universe. If you want to work out the circumference, then we times it by pi. So the circumference would be pi times the diameter. What's the difference when I take away my truncated pi? What I mean is, what if I took away my pi with 39 digits, I've called it pi 39, and did the same thing, times by d. So that's the real circumference of the universe. Take away my approximation. What's the difference? If I do that, what I got was actually round about 2.5 times 10 to the minus 12 meters. So that's how accurate. That's the difference between my approximation and the real value. That's how accurate it is. And a hydrogen atom, Wolfram Alpha told me, had a diameter of about 2.5 times 10 to minus 11 meters. So in fact, this is more accurate. This is more accurate than a hydrogen atom. So why do we calculate pi to 10 trillion digits? These days, it's a way to test our computers, our supercomputers and our algorithms. It's a way to test them to see how good they are. That's why computer scientists are interested in this sort of thing. Mathematicians have tried to do this for thousands of years out of curiosity. And so it started with Archimedes. He tried to get an accurate idea of pi around about 250 BC. He didn't have decimals in those days. He had to use fractions, but he had tried to work it out. Then in the 17th century, there was a Dutch mathematician called, now I'll probably anglicise his Dutch name, I apologise. He was called Ludolf van Kulen. And his life's work was working out the digits of pi. And by the end of his life, he had worked out 35 digits of pi, and on his tombstone, which is kind of cool, isn't it? Kind of neat. We skip on to the 19th century. There was a guy who had about 707 digits of pi. This was the authoritative example of pi for 100 years, until 1945, and they found a mistake. I know, shock horror. They found a mistake, and the last 180 digits were wrong. Because somewhere along in his calculations, somewhere around the 500th decimal point, he had made a mistake. And from that point on, everything else was wrong. What a disaster. Fortunately, we were able to use computers by this point. So in 1949, ENIAC, the American computer, was able to calculate pi to 2,000 digits. So suddenly it just exploded after that. Once we've got computers, it just exploded. We had more and more digits of pi, and now we've got 10 trillion digits of pi.
Wow.